Image recording devices. Before the light image coming from the image intensifier is processed for the display system, it's always transmitted through a bundle of optic fibers directly to a CCD or a CMOS camera. The CCD, or charge couple device, was introduced in the 1980s, and the technology allowed for the creation and marketing for home camcorders as it replaced the TV camera tube. The CCD is a small, flat plate approximately 1 centimeter in length and breadth for a home camcorder. The type used in fluoroscopy are about 2.5 centimeters, coupled to the 2.5 centimeter output phosphor. In fluoro, it's coupled by a short bundle of optic fibers, as opposed to an optical lens option, which would allow for distortion effects like vignetting. The CCD's sensitive surface is made of crystalline silicon, a semiconductor. When light photons exiting the image intensifier tube interact with the silicon layer of the CCD, ionization of the molecules separates electrons from them, leaving positively charged electron holes behind. A layer of microscopic electrodes beneath the silicon is given a negative charge, and a dielectric layer above acts as a ground for the freed electrons. The electrons then drift toward a dielectric layer, and the positively charged holes drift towards the electrodes. This drift consists of a series of electrons moving up to fill each vacancy in the molecule above, in sequence, so the vacancy itself, or the hole, appears to drift in the opposite direction. When a hole reaches the electrode, it pulls an electron from it, creating a positive charge on the electrode, which can easily be measured by the circuit. This charge is then collected within a storage capacitor. Thin film transistors are used in direct conversion systems to form an active matrix array, which, once scanned, sends an electric signal to an amplifier to become digitized and stored, and ultimately is sent to the display system. The CCD has a high sensitivity, or DQE. DQE stands for detective quantum efficiency. If we get one electron for each light photon being emitted by the image intensifier, we would have 100% quantum efficiency. But as you already know, anytime energy is transformed, we lose a certain percentage of that efficiency. The dynamic range of a CCD is about 3,000 to 1 for fluoroscopy. With direct conversion, the CCD produces high contrast and signal-to-noise ratio with almost no image lag, low blooming, and high resolution. Its resolution is determined by pixel count and physical dimensions. Your textbook provides an example of the CCD being 2.5 centimeters in size with a matrix of 2048 by 2048 pixels, making each pixel about 14 microns in size. Using progressive scanning, where each line of the raster pattern is read sequentially, the CCD can acquire images at 60 frames per second, compared to older TV camera tubes using interlaced scanning, only capable of 30 frames per second. CMOS, or complementary metal oxide semiconductors, were pioneered in the 1970s around the same time CCDs were being developed. The name refers to the use of two metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors, or MOSFETs, with one P-type, or positive transistor, and one N-type, or negative transistor. They stack together to form an electric logic gate. This became the dominant method for manufacturing integrated circuits for computers, but for cameras, CMOS circuits were inferior to the CCD. Both systems used the photoelectric effect to liberate electrons in a silicon layer and collect them as an electrical charge in a layer of transistors, but the primary difference is the method in which the charge is read from the chip. In CCDs, the charge is sent across the chip as an analog signal, read at one corner of the array, where fluctuations are separated into individual readings to represent pixels, then they are digitized. In CMOS sensors, each individual detector element, or dexel, has its own transistor, amplifier, noise correction circuit, and digitization circuit so that it outputs digital data that moves down traditional wires to exit the sensor. For the CCD, the signal uniformity is very high, while all of the added electrons for the CMOS reduce the surface area for light capture, resulting in a higher amount of image noise. Improvements in the 1990s to CMOS technology made it nearly equal to CCDs, and since the CMOS has a higher speed than the CCD, it only consumes about 1/100th of the power and can be manufactured less expensively.